Hi, I'm Bhavani Shankar, Assistant Professor of Chemistry, Sadiq Fakir, Government Boys Degree Board Admittee, Sarkarkar. Today we have another very important topic from Chapter 7 of first year, the balance of chemical equation by ion electron method. So in this balance, we have a type of reaction that it is called redox reaction. So in this redox reaction, we have the example of permanganate ion that taken from potassium permanganate, the oxalate ion taken from oxalic acid, and as you know, when the redox reaction takes place, manganese which contain plus 7 oxidation state in permanganate ion is to be converted into manganese plus 2 ion, and in oxalate ion the carbon possesses oxidation state of plus 3. Definitely it will be converted, when it is converted into carbon dioxide having oxidation number of plus 4. So in these two we can say the oxidation and the reduction takes place, and you know this redox reaction, it may be either to be taken in or carried out in an acidic medium or basic medium. Sometimes we have a neutral as well. So in this case, this redox reaction is taken in acidic medium. So that's why we have to indicate this one by proton. So the first part of balance of equation is the what we call the split. The step one, the split of this equation into two halves, and those two halves are expressing the reduction and oxidation. So from first part, that it is from potassium permanganate we have a manganate ion, and from manganate ion we have the conversion of manganese from plus 7 to plus 2. So that it is indicating here plus 7 to plus 2, that we have a decrease in charge called reduction. And in oxalate ion, the carbon which possesses oxidation state of plus 3, so when it is converted into carbon dioxide, so the oxidation number of carbon will be changed from plus 3 to plus 4, that's we have the increase and called oxidation. So after doing this one, means after the completion of the step first, we come to the step 2. And that step is telling us the balance of atoms other than oxygen and hydrogen. So now we have to check the atoms other than oxygen and hydrogen. We have the manganese and we have the carbon. So in manganate ion, you know, we have one manganese from on the left side and one on the right side. Whereas in oxalate ion, we have two carbons. So we have to put the coefficient 2. This coefficient can balance the carbon. So for this balance of carbon, we have to put this coefficient to make balance for the carbon. So that we have the step 2. And when we come to the step 3, that step it is again telling you the balance of atoms, but this time we have a balance of oxygen and hydrogen. And in this stage, you know, we have to mention whether this redox reaction it is carried out either in acidic or basic medium. And for acidic medium, the balance of oxygen it is carried out by the addition of water molecules, while that of your hydrogen we have to put proton on the opposite side. So in this case, as you know, we look at this one. In the first one, the permanganate ion, we have this manganese, so we have 4 oxygen on the left, and on the right we have no oxygen. So that's why for balance of these 4 oxygen, we have to put 4 water. So this 4 water means each water contains 1 oxygen, so that can balance the oxygen on the both side. And as you know, when water is added, what happened? We have the increase in the number of hydrogen. So for the balance of hydrogen, we have 8 hydrogens, so that's why we have to put 8 proton on the left to balance the 2. And in the second part, the oxalate ion and the carbon dioxide,
where we have already balanced our oxygen. That we have 4 oxygen on the left and 4 oxygens are present on the right. So this is already balanced. So now we come to the most important part of the balance of equation by ion electron method is what the step 4, where you have to say we have a balance of charges. First we have to follow to the charges, the number of charges on the left and right. 8 proton means 8 plus positive charges, 1 minus charge means overall charges are present on the left are 7 plus and on the right it is plus 2. So what we can do? We cannot increase the number of charges in positives on the right, but we can decrease from plus 7 to plus 2 by adding 5 electrons. So when 5 electrons are added, what happens? Because as you know, it is already mentioned that this half, it is a reduction. So definitely we have the addition of electron, and when you have to add 5 electron and then check the number of charges, then you can find what it is balanced. And likewise in oxalate ion we have overall charges minus 2, and on the right the carbon dioxide as a whole it is a neutral. So for the balance of what the negative 2, we have to put 2 electrons on the right, because this is oxidation, so we have the loss of electron. So in this way we have the charges which are to be balanced in step 4. But as you know, the loss and gain of electron during redox reaction will be equal, that we have equal number of charges are to be added and to be released are to be loosed. So now we have step 5, where we have to balance the electrons. So how those electrons are to be balanced? By multiplying. And how this is to be multiplied? As we have finding that 5 electrons are added, 2 electrons are to be lost, so they are to be balanced by multiplying this 5 by 2 and 2 by 5 as whole. So whole equation is to be multiplied, and this we have a multiplication of this equation by 2. So we have to put 2 over here, we have 16 proton, we have 10 electron, and then we have 2 manganese plus ion, and we have 8 water. And likewise when we have to multiply this one by 5, then this oxalate ion become 5, and we have 10 carbon dioxide and 10 electrons. So in this way the electrons are to be balanced in step 5, and in step 6 and the last one, where what happened, we have to add the 2 half, means the oxidation half and the reduction half, which we have to split it in step 1, now they are to be added. So on addition, that we have a permanent ion, that's 2, then we come to the 5 oxalate ion, and then we have no proton on either side, so we have to keep 16 proton, and these 10 loss and gain of electrons are to be cancelled out, means balanced, so they are to be cancelled out. And on the right side we have 2 manganese, and then we come to the carbon dioxide, we have 10 molecules, and then we have 8 molecules of water. And now we have to check what all number of atoms. So we have overall 2 manganese atoms for on the left, and 2 are here. And as whole oxygen 2 into 4 8, and 5 into 4, that's 20, means we have overall 28 oxygens are present on the left. And in this what right side, we have 10 into 2, 20 oxygen, and 8 of water become 28. And then we have carbon, 5 into 2, 10, and they are 10. And we have 16 proton, and 2 into 8, it is 16. So this equation now is going to be balanced. And this is what the method through which we can make equation balanced. In this case, that was an acidic medium. We had a basic medium, then just to change the pattern of oxygen and hydrogen. If basic medium is there, then just to for the balance of oxygen, we have to put hydroxide ions, and for the balance of hydrogen, we have addition of water, it is carried out, and that we have the two
different pattern if it is carried out either in acidic medium or basic medium. So that is to be done. That's all about today's lecture. Thanks.